Welcome to the King Range National Conservation Area and the King Range Wilderness. This 5-minute video will present two important pieces of information that are required for safe travel along the Lost Coast Trail. First, you will learn how to look up tidal predictions, which is essential before booking a permit for overnight travel on the Lost Coast Trail. Second, you will learn how to look up ocean conditions, which are equally as important for safe travel along the coast. The Lost Coast Trail is not a beginner-friendly backpacking trip due to the physically grueling terrain and logistical challenges involved with planning a trip. It is vital for a Lost Coast Trail adventure to base your daily itinerary on the tides and to be flexible when ocean conditions force you to deviate from your plan. Offshore storms, high winds, and large swells can inundate sections of the Lost Coast with large waves, rendering them inaccessible and unsafe for passage at any tide height. There are multiple stretches of coastline that become impassable during high tides. From north to south, these impassable zones are Punta Gorda. This is an area of high concern during winter months due to offshore storms and large swells. This area is about a quarter mile in length and must be passed at a tide of less than 5 feet. Sea Lion Gulch to Randall Creek. The entirety of this section must be hiked at a tide lower than 2.5 feet due to two pinch points located just north of Kooski Creek and just north of Randall Creek. Many close calls are reported in this section. Please exercise extreme caution when passing Kooski Creek and Randall Creek. Big Flat to Gitchel Creek. The entirety of this section must be hiked at a tide lower than 3 feet. Split Rock. This area is located 1.5 miles north of the Black Sands Beach Trailhead. This large boulder field is constantly changing and has witnessed multiple losses of life due to large sneaker waves and a strong offshore rip current. Boulders up to 50 feet tall create blind spots, increasing the likelihood of being caught off guard and swept off your feet. The Bureau of Land Management strongly urges hikers to hug the bluff rather than hiking directly through the center of the boulder field. The coast is dynamic and continually changing. New pinch points may develop that aren't listed here. How to check the tides. Tides are based on the sun and moon's gravitational pull on our ocean. Therefore, tide predictions are reliable more than a year in advance. To check your tides, navigate to NOAA and find tide predictions for Shelter Cove, California. Input your planned dates. Change the data interval from high-low to 15 minutes. Under threshold value, enter the number 2.5 to signify a 2.5-foot tide height. Press the blue Plot Daily button to generate your tide predictions. When analyzing your updated tide chart, make sure that you have low tides well under 3 feet during daylight hours. How to check the ocean conditions. These detailed conditions vary day to day and must be reviewed prior to your start date. To check the marine forecast, navigate to NOAA. Find the forecast for Cape Mendocino to Point Arena. Note the winds, wave height, and period. Additionally, look for other hazardous conditions, such as small craft advisories. The Wilderness Permit System is based on 60 entrances per day from May to October and 30 per day from October to May. You must enter the wilderness on your permit start date. Starting on any other day renders your permit invalid and you are subject to fines. If conditions are unsafe on your entry date, do not go. Plan to traverse the impassable zones on a receding tide. If the tide is rising, you risk the possibility of getting stuck at a narrow pinch point, especially when faced with a combination of large swells and high winds. This scenario also leaves you with limited time to hike backwards before the incoming tide cuts you off. The rocky and sandy terrain of the coastline will slow even the most experienced backpackers. It is strongly advised that you plan for a pace of 1 mile per hour along the coast, especially through the impassable sections. The ocean is breathtakingly beautiful, but beware. Hikers of all experience levels have lost their lives on the Lost Coast Trail. Rogue waves and sneaker waves, steep drop-offs, powerful shore breaks, and a strong rip current are all threats along our coastline. Never turn your back on the ocean. Do not hike on wet sand and distance yourself far from the shore break. No beaches along the Lost Coast are safe for swimming. Conservative decision-making and calculated risk management can help mitigate some of the dangers of coastal hiking. Please check our website for additional resources and call the BLM Visitor Center for all other questions.